Street art is part of the culture in many American cities. It ranges from common graffiti sprayed by vandals to beautiful public art commissioned by cities and building owners. And it also includes advertising paid for by corporations. Legal street art has made its way into the mainstream, like the iconic Hope poster from the 2008 Obama campaign, which was created by street artist Shepard Fairley. Now, the works of British street artist Banksy have been sold for $600,000, and his artwork is highly coveted by collectors. About 80% of graffiti is tagger graffiti, sprayed on the walls by suburban teenagers, according to Keep America Beautiful. Kids do it for fame, rebellion, and self-expression, and it's illegal. A city like Chicago spends more than $6 million a year to clean up graffiti. But public art is considered culturally enriching and socially desirable. It can include guerrilla sculptures, sticker art, and street posters too. So what should you do if you want to create street art? For private property, get permission from the owner and make sure that you have a written contract. Among other things, spell out who owns the copyright to the work. You don't want to find out that prints are being made of your artwork and that you don't own the rights. Second, be sure that the city allows property owners to display art on their walls. In some cities, it is illegal for landowners to allow any graffiti on their walls if it's visible from any other property. Third, check with the local or state commission for the arts and determine if the government is requesting proposals to create works for public places. You could get paid handsomely for artwork that would otherwise be considered a crime. How cool is that? If you want more information on street art, check out the Wooster Collective. This website is the best destination to find videos, lectures, and lists of street artists with links to their professional websites. This is Larry Bodine for Lawyers.com.